YouTubers, so this will be my second review on obviously a perfume, and I've chosen Paris Hilton's whole passport collection. Like, I literally own so many bottles at this moment, so I thought I might like just do all of Paris's first and then like move on to like all the other celebrities, like for example like Britney, J-Lo, Kim Kardashian, etc. So I hope you enjoyed my review of Paris Hilton's passport. Alright, okay, so like the first fragrance I'm gonna review is Passport in Paris, and that's, well, I'll tell you more of the information about it now because I'm gonna show you the box, move all the other fragrances away and just have the Paris one, and then I'll explain it to you then. Okay, so now the first one I'll be doing is the Passport in Paris, and to be honest, this is actually one of my favourite scents in the Passport collection, because with me I love sweet smells, and this is a sweet scent. So basically, I'll talk about the bottle, I'll talk about the box design, and also like what this like some website has to say about the ingredients, and like obviously like just everything about it really. So let's start off with the bottle. So basically, right, I can't see this much. This is the bottle, this is the 100ml, and with the Passport collection, you actually only come in the 30ml, which is the 1 ounce, and the 100ml, which is the 3.4 ounce. Like, I don't know why it doesn't come with 50ml, but hey, still amazing as they are. So basically, with the Passport in Paris, it's basically just like a gold, like, little plastic cap. I think it's pretty, like, snazzy and cute. And then just like a silver like nozzle for the spray. And then basically around the bottle is obviously like Paris. Obviously in Paris with a pink Eiffel Tower right there, which you can tell it's gonna be Paris. Then obviously says Paris Hilton. Oh god, the light. Paris. And then the colour of like the scent is like an orangey like kind of colour, so it's more like, to me I think it's kind of more of like an autumn scent. Like, I think it's so adorable, but like even with the 30ml and 100ml, it's a sticker because obviously there it shows that you can peel it off, so it's not actually on the glass. So that's like what it is as well. So that's the bottom. These are the 30ml bottles. They're obviously much smaller, they're obviously still the same, nothing different about them. But the reason why I've actually got so many is because I collected like all three bigger sizes first. And then when it came to Christmas, I was buying my friend one, which was, oh wait, not my friend, my cousin one, which was this one actually. And I got one for free. Like, you buy two and you got another one for free. So I got basically that one for free. So I got that one to my cousin, and I kept the Tokyo and South Beach. Sorry, I think I'm going a bit crazy. But basically, so I basically kept them, and I've literally got like 10 bottles to do with like the whole Passport collection, which is like crazy because it's like, Luke, you need to calm down a little bit, but hell no, sister. So basically, the box design, like, let me just like move a bit forward. Hopefully nothing. I was like, start the video, but I meant to say, hopefully, I hope nothing falls. But right, onto the box. So basically, I think it's like a really cute design box. Why is it so bright? Like, I don't know if it's my light. Like, let me just like try turning my light off. I feel like I make it much darker now, isn't it? Right, I'll have to do. So basically, when you obviously open it, it's obviously got Paris's like little P logo, well, not the actual logo, but quite of a logo. And then obviously it's got the cute little avatar of Paris with it standing with the Eiffel Tower. Here is his Paris Hilton passport, which I find adorable because I think the colours go well together. And then when you like look at the sign and stuff, like there's like Paris's like logo and stuff. I absolutely adore it. Sorry, it's not so clear. And then that just goes like around, but then it's just Paris wearing her chic outfit, like looking fabulous as usual. And basically, that's the box for 100ml. The 30ml box is just literally the same, but obviously smaller. Has all the ingredients and like all the information on the back here. And then tells you obviously there like how much you have to use it upon. So it says 36 months, so that's 3 years. You have to use it in. So yeah. But now I'm gonna move on to the scent and then I'll tell you more about that and explain more about it. So yeah. Right, okay, so now I'm gonna talk about the scent. And I've got like a lot of testers, these are like One Direction ones because it's so cute. So I'm gonna like use it on this, but what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna spray it on air first, let it settle down so I can like explain more of it to you. And then I'm gonna like read about the fragrance and when it was like launched and stuff and all that kind of stuff. So I'll have to spray as well. So basically, Paris works with a company called Pollux Fragrance, Pollux Company. But they obviously do like fragrances for like other celebs, like such as I'm sure they do like Rihanna, like celebrities such as them and stuff. The reason why Paris actually done the Passport collection was obviously it's inspired by her whole jet set of life and how she travels around the world. And obviously it's like, it says here, the collection represents a journey that takes a girl next door to exotic locations featuring three fragrances, Paris, Tokyo and South Beach. So basically, Paris wants to basically capture the whole moment, like when she's in these kind of countries, and she obviously wanted to put it more into a scent and stuff so she could describe to like her fans and like other like people on like how she thinks that country like probably smells like to her or something. But I thought it was like a pretty cute idea and stuff. Like obviously with me, I love these designs and stuff. I love the bottles, the scent. That's why I got like 10 of them. Like, wow, I'm like crazy, but oh well. So, yeah, so basically this was, like, launched in 2010, and obviously, like I said before, it only comes in the 30ml and the 100ml, which is the 1 ounce and 3.4 ounce. But the scent, it basically, it opens with notes of sparkling mandarin, juicy red berries, and golden peach. The heart is composed with sambac jasmine, honeysuckle, and purple peony, while the base consists of vanilla, amber, patchouli, and creamy white musk. So that is what, like, the scent is described as. So I find it, like, really adorable and, like, so quiche. Like, so adorable. So now I'll talk about the scent, if I like it, and, yeah. So here goes. Like, just to say now, Tokyo was actually my favourite one out of the whole collection. But then as soon as I got Paris, like, because I'm more into, like, the sweet smells. Like, I love fresh smells, which is which Tokyo is, but I thought, I don't know, I've lent more towards the Paris instead, because obviously I'm more into sweet scents, but yeah, I'm gonna like move on to that like one soon, like I'll do Tokyo next. But basically, like, apparently this is like, scent is described as like a touch of vanilla, and I can smell that vanilla a lot in this fragrance, but I think it actually goes really well. Like, what else can I smell? I can definitely smell the mandarin. Like, that's cute. The golden peach. Wait. Like, it is quite a strong fragrance, actually, even though it's an eau de toilette. I think that's how you say it or something. I sound stupid if I've just basically said it wrong. But an eau de toilette. I don't know, but oh well. But basically, I think with Paris's Passport in Paris one, this is the strongest out of them all. Like, whenever I spray it, like, toilet doesn't, like, last as long because it's not, like, a perfume. But this one does last a hell of a lot longer than a lot of perfumes I've actually got. Because, like, I'll spray it, and then it's, like, you obviously won't smell it as much, but then it's, like, as soon as, like, you walk around, like, a corner, or, like, you get, like, a breeze or something, you can just instantly smell it. And that's what I love about it, because I love fragrances that, like, last a long time. And I think with this, the lasting power is at least between, like, 4 to, like, 6 hours. Like, maybe, like, a little more than that. Like, it just depends if it's, like, if it goes well on your skin and stuff. But I do basically recommend this, like, fragrance to, like, anyone, really, because it's such an amazing, beautiful, sexy scent, and it's hot. And obviously it's Paris Hilton, so, of course, it's hot. But that's my one on Paris, and now I'm going to be doing Tokyo. Okay, so, like, now I'll be doing the passport in Tokyo. So, I'll talk about the bottle first and, like, the whole design of it, and then I'll move on to, like, the actual box and then the scent. So, basically, I have two 100ml, like, and a 30ml as well. Like, the reason why I, like, have two 100ml is basically because on this website I use, allbeauty.com, they sell these ones for $9.99 each, and I think this site is amazing. That's where I always buy my Paris ones from, and I love it. So I bought this one, and obviously when I bought the other three, like, all three of them at Christmas and stuff, I gave obviously one to my cousin. And then obviously I was with another Tokyo and South Beach, so I basically got an extra bottle. But I actually literally, well, I won't spoil it, but I do love the scent. Well, I was kind of spoiled by it well. So yeah, I got that one. But this was like the first size I ever got, because what I done was I got Paris, South Beach, and Tokyo on, like, one little gift set for, like, £15. And I thought, well, that, you can't, like, give up on that. Like, it was, like, an amazing price. So, I obviously got it then. So, I now have, like, three bottles and stuff. So, you go, Luke. So, oh, God. Basically, it's just, like, the same, obviously, kind of bottle. It's, like, the original Paris Hilton one she ever done. Like, I love that fragrance. Oh, my God. But basically, it's just, like, a nice little pinky kind of, like, lid. It's, like, adorable. And, like, obviously, the silver nozzle. Still, like, the same, like, avatar, like, kind of person. Like, but, like, in a nice, like, Japanese kind of, like, outfit, which is cute. Also, like, all the Japanese, like, trees and, like, flowers and stuff. I love the touch of that. So, that is, like, a bottle. And obviously, with Tokyo, it only comes in a 1 ounce and 3.4 ounce, which is the 30ml and 100ml. So, no, 50ml. So, sorry, guys. Obviously, they had a big bottle. It's the same. Obviously, the stickers still, like, peel off. So, that's not the best thing, but it's still cute. So, okay, now the box design is, like, I don't have the box for the 30ml since it came, like, a little gift set. All it came in was this kind of, like, box. So, that's what it came in. So, yeah. But basically, here's the box. Like, obviously, might see it better there. There's Paris. But, like, I just love, like, the texture of it, really. Like, I just love, like, the whole chic, like, outfit and stuff. It's so cute. I just love, like, how the whole, like, how it's just laid out and stuff. I just think it's just, like, it's so Paris, but it's shown, like, a different side of fragrances, I think, and stuff, like, because a lot of people just, like, they need to make it look amazing. Like, don't get me wrong, these do look amazing, but I just love how they've gone, like, how Paris has gone, like, more into, like, a character and stuff, and she's, like, made it so people can feel as if they're her when they travel and stuff to these kind of, like, places, so obviously such as Tokyo, Paris, South Beach, St. Moritz. That's, like, the fourth one, but I'll explain that one soon. But I just think it's so cute, like, how Paris has, like, made, like, these, because I really think they're so adorable. And, yeah, just the cutest ever. And I love all of Paris's products. I just think they're amazing. But now I'm going to talk about the scent now, so I'll get on with that. Okay, so, like, what I did before with Paris is, like, sprayed it, told you, like, the notes and stuff. I'm going to do the same, because obviously it can be a little strong at the beginning, so it's kind of overbearing. Like, that's what I like strong fragrances, because you know they're going to last long. So what I'll do, I'll just spray this, and then I'll tell you about the notes and stuff. Oh, beautiful scent. So basically, this was also launched as well in 2010, which, like, obviously the same as Paris. I think they're all launched in 2010, really. But this is what the, like, notes are. It says, Passport Tokyo opens with notes of lemon and red apple. The heart is made of frangipani or frangipani iris, which is apparently an expensive ingredient to put in fragrances. So it's like, oh, you go Paris. Orange blossom and jasmine. Place on the base of the golden cedar, clay musk, and sandalwood. So basically, that is like what is in the whole fragrance. Like, hopefully it's died down a little. So I'll tell you like what I think of the scent. So basically, when I like smell Tokyo, it is such a fresh scent. Like, obviously I do love my fresh scents. I love like a lot of scents, like sweet. I like the sophisticated kind of scents and like fresh scents. I just like a lot, really. But basically, like, you can smell like the whole lemon mainly in it and stuff. Like, that's like the main like scent I can usually smell and stuff. Like, it's actually one of my favourites and stuff. Like, obviously the time to like wear this kind of perfume is like obviously summer, so obviously summer's not far away from me. So I really cannot wait to start wearing it. Because obviously, like, if you look, I've not used as much, but obviously I've been using quite a bit, actually. So, yeah, I really can't wait to, like, start using them, like, in the summer, because I'll just be like, Paris Hilton, bitch. So, that's sort of, like, what I'll be doing, like, most, like, wearing my Paris ones. Like, there's so many, like, summer scents I've got. I've got, like, Nicki Minaj, Pink Friday, Minajesty, obviously the Passport ones. I've also got Siren, Just Me. These are like by Paris as well. Paris Hilton for Women, the men's ones. They're adorable. Katy Perry, Killer Queen, Oh So Sheer. That's the newest like fragrance by. The One Direction Our Moment, I would definitely use for summer. Miami Glow, definitely. That is beautiful. Island Fantasy by Britney. And there's literally just so many what I can choose from for the summer. But yeah, that was basically for Tokyo. And now I'm going to move on to South Beach. That's it. Okay, so like now I'm going to be doing like the Paris Hilton Passport South Beach, which is adorable. But first I'm just going to like, I might as well actually just like spray the scent now. So I'm not like, I don't know, like wait and stuff. Oh wait, that's the wrong one. That's the one. Let's just spray it on. Right, so I'll just leave that. So basically, I'm going to talk about the bottle first. Like, I love the bottle. Like, this time it's like a nice little blue cap. And to be honest, like, blue is my favourite colour. So I adore it. Obviously, it's got Paris. Like, I think it's like, is it Miami? I'm sure it's Miami. With the, like, sexy palm trees. Like, in a bathing outfit and, like, her amazing hat. She just looks so glamorous as usual. And obviously, it's still the same. You can peel the sticker and stuff off, like, which kind of sucks, but oh well. But yeah, like, I love this bottle design and stuff. It has, like, buildings and, like, a beach. Like, it's got the places such as the Cabana, the Oasis, Sobe or something. And Nikki as well, which is adorable. So that's that. And then now this is, like, a box. This is, like, adorable. It's just obviously, it's still all the same designs and stuff, but obviously different like kind of characters. Oh, why is it so like that? Like, seriously, who, what is life? But basically it's just like the same like designs and stuff, but obviously just like different, just like different patterns and like different like design stuff, since it's like different countries and stuff. Like Paris, the Eiffel Tower. Then obviously South Beach is obviously more like of a beachy kind of theme, and obviously Tokyo is more of like a fresh like kind of like theme and stuff, showing off all like the beauty of Tokyo and stuff, which I find like is adorable. So they're the bottles, and they obviously just come in 130 mils, which is the 1 ounce and 3.4 ounce, but no 50 mils. But
oh yeah,
so I was river tweeting then, you go river. Oh god. So now like what I'm gonna have to do first is just like get up the scent. Like, let me just like find it, because then I can tell you what it is. So, and then I'll rank them of, like, my favourite ones and stuff, and tell you about them and stuff. So, obviously, South Beach was obviously mentioned, and was also launched in 2010. So, basically, South Beach, Paris, and Tokyo were all presented in 2010. Right, this is what it has to say. Passport South Beach opens with juicy nectarine, which you can smell a lot. Lotus and white freesia, I think it's that, or freesia, yeah, I'm sure it's that, followed by the heart of, oh god, what is this word, osmanthus, I'm so sorry, I'm like useless at these kind of words sometimes, but I will. Marigold and jasmine and the base of Australian sandalwood, musk and blonde woods. So, I'm quite Australian there with Australian sandalwood. That's pretty cute. But I think this is a beautiful scent. Like, obviously I'd wear it when I go to the beach, but obviously I would still wear it for like summer and stuff. Like, I'd definitely wear it for summer because it's like, it's such like, I just love Paris's scents really. But yeah, but now the last one I'm going to be reviewing is Saint Moritz. So I'll do that now. Right, okay, so this is my last one to review now, because I never usually do like, oh, sorry, my neck's really so sore. Oh, well. But yeah, this is Saint Moritz. Like, let me just like get up the page. Like, obviously the bottle is obviously just sort of like the same design and stuff, like, all like kind of like different, like, obviously like little avatars. This one is obviously Paris, like, going skiing, and obviously Saint Moritz. It'll be, and to be honest, I think it's so adorable and stuff. Like, I'm so sorry I'm like taking so long, but I just have to type in Paris Hilton Passport Saint Moritz, and then just like get like the whole page up. Right, there it is. Come on, hurry. It's loaded on the page now, and it's on. Right, okay. So basically, this, I've only got a 30ml of this, which is the 1 ounce bottle, and the reason why is because the All Beauty website I use only has the 30ml. If they're the 100ml, then like, I'll definitely get it. But I found like another site called Galaxy Perfume, not good at UK, and they sell it, so I might order it off there soon. So yeah, so adorable, and another like blue kind of lid, which I adore. And it goes well with the bottle and the theme, because obviously when I think of like it being like cold and stuff, I just think of blue for some reason. I know, it's strange, but I will. Then obviously there's like Paris is like a little avatar with like a little snowboard of obviously like, look, what can't see but a little Tinkerbell, so adore. But wait, let me show you the box. Like, you see like Tinkerbell there, it's so adorable. But yeah, like, I love this like scent. Oh god, so much and stuff. It's dead like icy, like frozen, like cold kind of scent, which I love. But what I'll do now is I'll spray it on the tester and I'll tell you about it and tell you like what's in the scent, and then I'll rank my whole perfume thing after. So basically, Passport Saint Moritz can be purchased as 30 and 100 mils, which is obviously the 1 ounce and 3.4 ounces, and this one actually came on the market in 2011 in autumn, so this was like obviously the fourth one to the collection and stuff. I hope like Paris has more of them, because I actually think they're really adorable and I'll definitely buy them. But I'd love to see Paris like promote them more in the UK and stuff, because I never even see any of her fragrances in like any shops. The only ones I really see is Eros, Cancan, and Paris Hilton. But a lot of people, like, I've heard, like, buy them and then they don't smell as they should do. So I don't know if it's either, like, the shop or something. But I just wish they're, like, in shops like Debenhams and stuff, because they're, like, the shops I go to. But yeah, me blubbering on as usual. But basically, in the top nose of Passport Saint Moritz offers a fresh ivy, frozen lemon, Anjou pear, ice, fresh winter air, and green leaves, which highlights winter idyll, or idyll. In cold winter days is inspirational to the fragrant journey. A heart incorporates freesia, white peony, lily of the valley, sandbach jasmine, and blue poppy flower, along with a base composed of white crystal amber, musk, and eco sandalwood. So she's gone quite eco in there, which I find adorable. But yeah, like, I won't really wear this like scent unless it's like the winter or like on a really cold day. Or like, I'd say like the autumn as well, because obviously it was released in autumn, so it'd be good to be in the autumn. But I won't really like, I don't know how. I probably would wear it for the summer, but it's not really a summer scent. But that's my opinion, really. So, like, seriously, when you like smell Saint Moritz, it's like, it just has that like frozen, nice, fruity kind of like scent to it. It is quite strong and stuff, but to be honest, like, perfumes are much better like when they're strong and stuff, because obviously, last longer, girl. Come on. To be honest, it's amazing. Like, to it, just buy all of the like passport. They're so cheap, like definitely in America. You can find them in a lot of like stores for like TJ Maxx and stuff like that. But they are so like definitely worth the buy. You would not be disappointed by them. But now I'll tell you my favourite ones, like from rank 1 to 4, and say like why it's my favourite and all that kind of stuff. So yeah. Right, okay. So what I'm gonna say, I'm gonna put like my favourite first. So my favourite actually has to be Paris, because obviously I'm into more of the sweet scents and I love it so much. So I'm gonna lie into it. But yeah, I love this scent so much. I love the sweetness of it. I love the like vanilla touch to it. Like, I adore that. Oh, it's beautiful. So I'm going to crown that as my like winner. So it's going to become first. Wait, I really, like, I shall be doing this like fourth, then to first, but oh well. My second favourite has to be... Oh God, I break it now, Luke. Can't do the lap like it did in the last video nearly. Tokyo, and that's because obviously I like my fresh scents, and this is definitely a fresh scent. So if you're into fresh scents, then buy Tokyo. If you're into sweet scents, obviously buy Paris. You would not be disappointed. My third favourite has to be St. Moritz, because I do like the frozen like kind of scents with. If I could, I'd actually put it joint second with Tokyo, because they're not similar, but to me, like, they're hot for certain occasions, and it's adorable. And obviously, I'll put it in third place, is South Beach, because obviously, like, it's dead a lovely smell, I love it so much, but, like, I don't know, like, I just don't, like, usually wear this as much. I'm basically either Tokyo or Paris. I don't wear St. Moritz as much as well, because, to be honest, I don't want to waste it, since I've only got 30 mil, but I can definitely order more, since it is quite cheap. But, I'd say the main one is probably Tokyo, I actually wear the most. But, oh god, I kind of burped then, oh well. I said oh well quite a lot of times, but basically that is my review for South Beach, St. Moritz, Paris, and Tokyo. So, if you like fresh scents and like kind of like cold, icy, frozen scents, then obviously go for Tokyo as the fresh one, and St. Moritz as kind of like the frozen like kind of scent, which is beautiful. For like when you go like skiing and stuff like that. South Beach for definitely like when you go days out on the beach. Wear it in the summer, definitely. It's cute. Paris, definitely for autumn. I won't really say it's summer because it's a bit too strong for summer, but I'm still gonna wear it in summer because like, I'm gonna rock it out, like yeah. But basically like autumn. I do kind of like think like when it's kind of like cold because it's got a nice little warm little scent to it where you're just thinking we just like want to cuddle up to someone and just be like, smell my bitch. But yeah, like, it's kind of suitable for a lot of occasions because it's quite, like, a warm, tasteful scent, and that's what I love about it the most. So that's why that is basically my favourite. So, yeah, you will seriously not be disappointed by Paris's perfumes. They are beautiful. You will love them. Like, they're just so fabu. Like, they're just, like, so cute and stuff. And they're really cute designs and stuff. They got cute boxes. There's lovely smells. And to be honest, I think you should buy them anyway, like, because they're, like, to be honest, like, they're amazing scents. I don't know if that's just obviously my opinion, but I'm sure a lot of you would like it. Okay, so obviously that I've done, like, 4 scents in one video, which is, like, wow. But that is my fragrance review done now. So I'll probably, like, either post in, like, the next few days or something, like, in a week. I don't like when we post, like, once every month or once every few weeks, because I don't know, I like doing this because it's, like, so fun, and, like, it obviously keeps me entertained. So, I'm going to try and do them, like, at least every few days, but when I'm in college, I usually get quite busy with work, but I will make time for fragrances because, to be honest, everything is about fragrances to me, so, booyah. So, I hope you loved this, like, review and stuff. I'll probably do, like, a Paris scent next, or if you check, like, my first video out, I've got every single fragrance, like, what I've shown in there, like, Nicki, J-Lo, Jessica Simpson, Kim Kardashian, Britney Spears, Taylor Swift, Katy Perry, Mariah Carey, One Direction, Justin Bieber. I just basically just say, like, what kind of scent you would want. Like, it's basically first come, like, whoever says it, then I'll definitely do it. But, like, comment, subscribe, tell me, like, what you think of the videos, and I'll see you next time with a different review.